Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mani Malathi, Assistant Professor of Economics, Sri Ramakrishna College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. And in this video, we are going to discuss about foreign capital and its various types. So these are the topics which we are going to discuss today. Introduction, types of foreign capital, foreign direct investment, and types of foreign direct investment, foreign portfolio investment, and difference between foreign direct investment and foreign portfolio investment. Let's see one by one. Let's start the presentation with the introduction of foreign capital. So the term foreign capital is a comprehensive one and includes any flow of capital in home country from abroad. So capital in economics includes all kinds of wealth used for the production of goods and services. So it can be a technical know-how, or it can be a machinery, or it can be a financial investment. So it's not just financial investment alone. So capital, when capital enters into an economy from abroad, is known as foreign capital. So foreign capital plays a significant role for every nation's economy, regardless of its level of development. Whether it is developing or developed, all the countries seek foreign investment for the purpose of economic development. And capital flows contribute in filling the resource gap in countries where domestic savings are inadequate to finance investment. And it is also necessary for macroeconomic stability, as it affects a wide range of macroeconomic variables like exchange rates, interest rates, foreign exchange reserves, saving, investment, and so on. And we all heard about economic reforms of 1991, and which was introduced to overcome severe economic crisis. And at that time, government can't able to make repayments on its borrowings from abroad. And new economic policy of 1991 created a conducive environment for foreign investors, mainly globalization. And these reforms were big twist in policy approach, which was changed to attract foreign capital, to modernize India's industrial base, as well as to improve export competitiveness. Need for foreign capital to fill the saving and investment gap. Since we all heard about a circular flow of income, and under circular flow of income, saving is identified as leakage and investment is identified as injection. And leakage should be equivalent to injection. Saving should be converted into investment. If it is not converted into investment, and there will be some gap, and this gap can be filled by foreign capital. And to fill the gap between targeted foreign exchange requirements and those derived from net export earnings plus net public foreign aid. So every country needs foreign capital for various purposes, for example, to pay for imports or for the creation of money and so on. And this can, and the difference between requirements and what it actually have can be filled by foreign investments or foreign capital. And fill the gap between governmental tax revenue and the locally raised taxes. If a government fails to make adequate tax revenue, then it can't able to spend for various developmental activities. And nowadays we can see foreign direct investments in various developmental activities like power distribution, water distribution, various infrastructure facilities, and so on. And to meet the gap in management, entrepreneurship, technology, and skill, if any country having a problem in these things, and this will be overcome by relaxing the regulations of foreign direct investment. Moving on, types of foreign capital. So foreign capital can be of various types, like foreign aid and grants. And foreign aid and grants are voluntary transfer of resources by governments, institutions, agencies, or organizations like World Bank, or from one country to another. And these foreign aid and grants are to overcome any specific needs like poverty, malnutrition, infant mortality, or to overcome any natural calamity like a tsunami or earthquake. And borrowings, which may take different forms, such as direct intergovernment loans or loans from international institutions like World Bank, IMF, and Asian Development Banks, and soft loans, for example, from affiliates of World Bank, such as International Development Associations, that is IDA, and external commercial borrowings. And deposits from non-resident Indians, or NRI. So NRIs are Indian citizens who live in another country. So if they deposit their earnings an Indian bank, then that will be a source of foreign exchange. And investments in the form of foreign portfolio investment in bonds, stocks, and securities, and foreign direct investment in industrial, commercial, and similar other enterprises. Next is foreign direct investment. So, foreign direct investment is defined as a process whereby a resident of one country acquires ownership of assets in another country, and such movement of capital involves ownership, control, as well as management of assets in the host country. And FDI are real investments in factories, assets, land, inventories, etc., and have three components like equity capital, reinvested earnings, and other direct capital in the form of intra-company loans. So equity capital in the sense that funds paid into business by investors in exchange for common or preferred stock, whereas reinvested earnings are taking earnings from your investments and using them to purchase additional investment products. And direct capitals are short-term loans used for quick financing. So FDI involves production of goods and services and the promotion of same to the customers in order to make profit. And then examples of FDI. So MNCs are the best example for FDI. So these are the top 10 MNCs in India. And FDI equity inflows into services and manufacturing sector from 2000 to 2019 is also shown here. And service sector attracts a high amount of FDI when compared to manufacturing sector. Almost 65% of the FDI falls under service sector rather than manufacturing sector. And next is role of FDI in employment generation in India. So Amazon plans to set up its second largest global delivery center outside the US in Hyderabad with the employment generation of 13,500 people. And PepsiCo plans to invest rupees 500 crore to set up another unit in Maharashtra to make various fruit juices. And Apple plans to build its first tech development center outside the US in Hyderabad with an investment of $25 million and employment generation of 4,500 people. And Indian Railways has issued a letter of award to General Electric for the purpose of diesel locomotive factory project in Bihar and to Alstom as well for the same purpose in Bihar. And Japan has won the right to construct India's first bullet train while offering a loan of $8.11 billion to India for the same. And Foxconn plans to invest $5 billion for setting up a manufacturing unit in Maharashtra with an employment generation of 50,000 people. So it is identified from various studies that there is a positive relationship between employment generation and FDI inflows. And this is the main reason why countries permit FDI into their economy. Next, we'll see nature of foreign investments. So FDI may be categorized as horizontal, vertical, and conglomerate investment. And first, we'll start with horizontal direct investment. And a horizontal direct investment is said to take place when the investor establishes the same type of business operation in a foreign country as it operates in its home country. For example, a cell phone service provider based in the United States moving to India to provide the same service. So in this type of investment, company does all the same activities abroad as at home. So it is just the extension of the same business operation in a foreign country. So vertical investment is one under which the investor establishes or acquires a business activity in a foreign country, which is different from the investor's main business activity. It in some way supplements to its major activity. For example, an automobile manufacturing company may acquire an interest in a foreign company that supplies parts or raw materials required for the company. Say, for example, Benz company wants to start a unit in India in order to produce spare parts, then that is known as vertical investment, whereas the final product will be produced in the home country. And next is conglomerate investment is one where an investor makes a foreign investment in a business that is unrelated to its existing business in its home country. So this is often in the form of a joint venture with a foreign firm already operating in the industry, as the investor has no previous experience. So investment is made to acquire an unrelated business abroad. And one more category is there, that is two-way direct foreign investment, which are reciprocal investments between countries that occur when some industries are more advanced in one nation while other industries are more efficient in other nations. So this is primarily a protection measure between countries that ensure investment between two or more countries is balanced. And this is more common in the case of custom union and trade union, where the countries are entered into an agreement between each other. Moving on, foreign portfolio investment. Foreign portfolio investment is the flow of financial capital with a stake in a firm at below 10% and does not involve manufacture of goods or provision of services, ownership management, or control of the asset on the part of the investor. Examples of FPI are the deposit of funds in an Indian or a British bank by an Italian company, or the purchase of a bond of a Swiss company or the Swiss government by a citizen or a company based in France. So unlike FDI, portfolio capital in general moves to investment in financial stocks, bonds, and other financial instruments as it is affected largely by individuals and institutions through the mechanism of capital market. And these flows of financial capital have their immediate effects on balance of payments or exchange rates rather than on production and income generation as in the case of FDI. So when the investment is less than 10%, then we can say that it is foreign portfolio investment. When the foreign investment exceeds 10%, then it is FDI. So, and FDI involves the production of goods and services, whereas FPI is the investment in financial stocks, bonds, and other financial instruments. And next is differences between foreign direct investment and foreign portfolio investment. So the first difference is FDI involves creation of physical assets, whereas under FPI, investment is only in financial assets. And FDI has a long-term interest and therefore remain invested for a long period, whereas FPI is only a short-term interest and generally remain invested for short periods. So FDI is a long-term investment and FPI is considered as short-term investment. And FDI is relatively difficult to withdraw, whereas FPI is relatively easy to withdraw. And FDI is not inclined to be speculative, whereas FPI is speculative in nature since it is invested in bonds and shares. And FDI is often accompanied by technology transfer, whereas FPI is not accompanied by technology transfer. And direct FDI has direct impact on employment of labor and wages since it is engaged in the production of goods and services and redistribution of same to the customers. Whereas FPI has no direct impact on employment of labor and wages because it consists only in the investment of in resources or money in stocks and shares. And next is FDI has enduring interest in management and control, which means long-lasting interest in management and control, whereas FPI has no abiding interest in management and control of the enterprise. And the last one is, securities are held with a significant degree of influence by the investor on the management of the enterprise, which means FDI investor extend their power in the management of the enterprise, whereas FPI investor cannot able to make any influence on the management of the enterprise. So let's have a quick recap of the concepts which we have discussed today. So we'll start with the meaning of foreign capital. So any inflow of capital from abroad is known as foreign capital. And next is types of foreign capital is of various types like foreign aid, grants, borrowings, deposits from NRI, investments in the form of foreign portfolio investment and foreign direct investment. And FDI are real investments in factories, assets, land, and inventories, etc. If the investment exceeds 10% of the total shares, then it is FDI. And then types of FDI is of three types like horizontal, vertical, and conglomerate. So horizontal investments are just the expansion of the same activity in the host country. Vertical investments are it is not exactly same, but it supplements to the major activity. And conglomerate investments are entirely different, where the foreign firms have no previous experience. And foreign portfolio investment is a flow of financial capital with a stake in a firm at below 10% and doesn't involve manufacture of goods and or provision of services, ownership management or control of the asset on the part of the investor. Thanks for listening. Thank you.